Hello and welcome to Aftomath History Series. Today we will talk about AS-44 history, specifically the 1944 Soviet assault rifle trial. In 1943, Soviet got several examples of MKB-42 from Germany in Kalinin, Volkov, and Leningrad front. This rifle was unique. Not only does it use intermediate cartridge, but the weight of this rifle is quote-unquote rather unique. When Soviet encounter German troop in Forest near Volkov, the environment was inefficient for submachine gun due to its poor power. Whilst the machine gun is too heavy and hard to maneuver around, the new German machine carbine proved to be good in this situation. It had maneuverability of submachine gun and firepower of machine gun in 400 meters. It's light and comfortable to use and shoot. The cartridges are designed by shortening the 8mm Mauser to simplify and ease the mass production. In war, Soviet learned that not more than 400 meters was the most ideal range for engagement and must not exceed 800 meters. With the new intermediate cartridge from Germany and the US, it made Soviet more and more interest to the assault rifle concept. In July 1943, the Soviet began to develop an intermediate cartridge. This decision was largely influenced by Lieutenant General Fedorov.
Wait a minute!
Is he the one who designed the Fedorov Automat? Okay. The design bureau worked on the new cartridge. The new cartridge should in 5.6, 6.5, and 7.62 in caliber size. After a series of tests, the caliber below 7.62 was deemed inefficient in stopping power. One project from OKB-44 are chosen. Elizarov, together with Fedorov, Tokarev, Shimonov, and Spagin. They are entrusted to further improve the design of the cartridge. And thus, the 7.62x41 was born. In September 1943, this cartridge was formally adopted as 7.62 cartridge model 1943. The production of the cartridge was carried out by plant number 543. In Kazan. In 1944, the mass production began. Also, in 1943, officer of GAU, together with designer from the Union, began working on a new small arm system with this new cartridge to replace the old system after the war. The new system is more unified,
just like the Union,
because all small arm use the same cartridge. In August 1943, GAU released the TTT, Tactical and Technical Requirement in Russia, number 245643, for small arm system. The initial primary requirement for the automat was, you must be bored if I read this, so you can pause and read it by yourself. In November 1943, the GAU announced a competition for the small arm system. This competition commission was headed by Deputy Head of Department of Handgun of Directorate Small Arm, GAU Engineer, Lieutenant Colonel A. Yabashmarin. For now, the design bureaus busy designing the automat. Some are as list KB2 and PKB-OGK. KB NIPS 4, KB of plan number 535, KB 180, Tesh KB 14, KB of plan number 367. At the beginning, GAU sees Automat as the universal firearm that combine all advantage of LMG rifle and SMG. Jack of all trades, master of all. Wait a minute. Maybe I heard this premise before.
Was the M14 or the rifle that was chosen to be the M14. It was supposed to have the firepower of the BAR, the lightweight of the carbine, controllability of the submachine gun, the accuracy of the M1. In the end, what did they get? They got a gun that wasn't even as good as the M1 Garand in reliability, and one that didn't replace any of the other ones because it was extremely heavy. It was difficult, if not impossible, to control for your average soldier on fully automatic. It did not replace any of those firearms. It was basically the exact same thing that they had. That was a problem.
Anyway, this scene by inclusion of a bayonet, bipod, and barrel length in the design. The design for Aftermath was diverse and varied from enlarged submachine gun, like machine gun.
Some of the LMG like Aftermath were transferred to LMG competition.
But most of the Aftermath design was influenced by MKB-42 and their previous or familiar design. According to the first test in NIPSFO in spring 1944, the competition commission concluded that none of the Aftermath design can replace the PPSH or the PPS. The commission recommend all the designers to improve their design. The first group recommend for the revision include Sudayev and Dektrayev. In second group, sample of KB-2 design, Shimonov and Korofin. All of the designer were given 1 month to meet the TTT. The next test was conducted on July 1st, 1944. For 2 months, Spagin design was not suitable for the intermediate cartridge due to the its system. Its total weight was 5.5 kg with the bolt at 1.2 kg. This exceeded the TTT. When shooting in burst or full auto, the AH has a tendency to have a violent vibration that can negate all the advantage of the new cartridge. AH was the most unstable design. Due to this, the competition only accept gas operate with strong locking automat. In the hot summer of 1944, all of automat are tested for survivability. Spagin automat withdrew from the competition after 315 shot. Dektrayev, Tokarev, Korofin, and other design bureau of Tomat failed test. Only the Sudayev AS-44 passed the test. And at the test, the AS-44 showed the least amount of malfunction and also scored the best accuracy. The AS-44 demonstrated a high survivability, operability, reliability of action in various working conditions. Through the creative talk and talent, make Sudayev finalize his design in a short time and submit the most acceptable aftermath for the summer test. Sudayev design can resist more dirt due to its dust cover and operate with long stroke gas piston and lock with tilting bolt. Its sight design range up to 800 meters and has a 30 round mag with a reinforced upper part. In autumn 1944, the competition commission concluded with the statement that AS-44 need battery test and small serial production. AS-44 were produced in spring 1945 at Tula plant number 536. 1000 AS-44 were produced by the factory, and in July 1945, it entered service trial at Moscow, Leningrad, Central Asia, Transcaucasia, and in Germany. The AS-44 fully met the requirement for the accuracy from firing with the bipod, almost equivalent to the DP-28 at range up to 600 meters. It surpassed the medium range effectiveness of SMG, but single shot accuracy is worse than the Mosin-Nagant.
Bruh.
The commission recognized that the AS-44 assault rifle successfully withstood the program of the military test, but suggests that the designer improved the maneuverability and wake. With the conclusion of the military test, the commission noted that, again, you can read it by yourself, but basically, it still can replace the SMG due to its maneuverability and firing accuracy. Position of the Avtomat as primary weapon was debated, but this argument was supported by Fedorov, as according to him, the war has proven that the combat range at 400 meters are ideal, and the continuous firing at that range produced good results. In October 1945, Sudayev had reduced the Avtomat weight to 4.8 kg, but it's still inferior compared to weight of submachine gun and accuracy at 200 meters. Based on the AS-44 test data, GAU announced a second competition. The Avtomat must replace the SMG and to be able to shoot at target at 500 to 800 meters. For now, the vision of Avtomat are more clear. All the sand abandoned the bayonet and bipod. The accuracy requirement are increased. For this competition, Sudayev sent his OAS, Oblikuny Avtomat Sudayeva. It had a weight of 4.77 kg with the magazine with no bipod and bayonet. However, at its factory test, OAS had less accuracy than the AS-44, and due to its reduced weight, the survivability of other parts are not satisfied, but Sudayev's design was still the most promising one. The Competition Commission made this following decision: the series manufacture of OAS for the field test is impractical without the preliminary refinement in order to increase the survivability of part and eliminate the shortcoming noted during the factory test. Sudayev enthusiastically began work on improving the rifle and managed to make a couple variants. But sadly, he died from sickness in 1946. Sudayev did not have any helper or student, so after his death, his work remained unfinished. The problem of creating an Avtomat continued to remain unresolved. Thanks for watching. The next episode will talk about AK-46 and 1946 trial. If you had a question about the AS-44 or the 1944 trial, you can comment down below. Source are in description down below. Special thanks to many for reviewing the script. Yarik and Draft for helping me with translation, and Kanata Hiba for helping with the art.